just this one. You can only imagine how hot it got in here with 15 running at the same time. We did have a temperature gauge on the back wall. It would read up to 57 degrees Celsius in here. It's a very hot environment to work in. Now inside the furnace, the gold sitting in a pot like this, called a crucible. It's made up of a mixture of clay and graphite. Withstand temperatures up to 1500 degrees. Each crucible costs us $110 and lasts 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, they start falling apart and breaking down. Look similar to this one here. We can no longer use them. We don't just throw them away. Over those 2 weeks, gold sinks inside the crucible itself. So we send them off to our refinery where they crush them up and send back, on average, $200 worth of gold. So you can imagine, 22 years ago, how excited they then got, ripping 14 old furnaces out of the wall. They realised potentially there could be a lot of gold inside the old furnaces themselves, ripped them out, crushed them up, and found more than $250,000 worth of gold. Now, running through the process is going to take today. Switch off the light, switch off the furnace, and lift up the lid. Grab these tongs here. These are the lifting tongs. Reach inside, lift out the crucible, place on the table. You can see the length of the handles. This is because the furnace is currently set at 1,200 degrees. I'm not going to put my hands inside. Now, gold melting point's 1,064. The reason we set it a few hundred degrees higher is I have enough time to bring the crucible across. Grab the pouring tongs and pour out the gold into the cast iron mould before it sets. Now gold does cool very, very quickly. It's only a matter of seconds until it's completely solid, so you've got to quickly get it across into the mould before that happens. Once it is in the mould, I'll switch my gloves, or flip it out onto this tray here and pull it down further in the water. Now this water, just so you do know, room temperature, nothing has been added to it. Quickly go through my safety gear. Firstly, this woolen vest. Now, wool's a great fire retardant. It doesn't ignite, it just smoulders. Over the top, this apron here. Now, this apron has three separate layers. The outside layer is aluminium used to reflect the heat. The inside, well, again, wire wool. Here we are, nice wool next to the furnace there. And in between is a thin layer of Kevlar. Kevlar is used in firemen's jackets and bulletproof vests. On my head, this helmet, again just to shield me from the majority of the heat. On my arms, these gloves. Now these gloves and these are very stylish boot covers I've got on as well, made out of the exact same material as the aprons, aluminium wool and Kevlar. And as I did mention before, I'll be switching gloves into these leather ones here, just to flip it out onto the tray. Now for the exciting part, I'll dim the lights up the top here. Fingers crossed goes to plan, we end up in the gold bar. Okay, as I was saying before, it is cooling very quickly. Watch closely enough, there's a dark ring making its way to the centre bar. Once it gets to the centre, that's when it'll solid the entire way through. a fresh bar of gold.
Oh, thanks, mate. And no, not too concerned if you do jump over, grab it, and run out the door about 600 or 700 degrees, and it'll make your hands catch on fire. Now, as soon as it goes into the water, loose the orange glow, starts to take on its usual colour. You go, nice gold shine to it. Again, still a few hundred degrees. Not going to touch it just yet. Now, this same bar of gold has been used for every single gold pour demonstration here at the Mint for the past 22 years. Not entirely sure why they chose that bar in the first place. Lucky piece of gold gets you to go from the furnace to the bowl to the water to the furnace 7 times a day, 7 days a week, meaning it has been poured out more than 50,000 times. And over those years, it has lost a slight amount of its purity. The gold we deal with here at the Mint, it is all 99.99%. It's as pure as gold gets. You can't quite get 100% gold. No guarantee, little bits of the crucible, other minerals haven't mixed with it during the process. So this bar here, we're saying, is 99.5 or higher. Anything of that grade is still classed as 24 karat gold. Now, pouring it out more than 50,000 times, it's also lost a slight amount of its weight. Mainly lost into the crucibles, did mention before we do get that back when we crush them up. Also, other gold pourers at work here, up itself, do spill a little bit on occasion. That is okay, we go around at the end of the day and sweep up this entire area. Anything left over goes into the back pocket. Superannuation. Now, this here is 6 kilos of gold, so 200 troy ounces, means I'm currently holding on to just over $350,000. At this point, slightly more concerned if you jump over, grab it, and run out the door, but that's where your big, strong security guards work in here, so we'll advise against it. Now, gold has always been in the Earth's crust. We're not actually entirely sure when it got there in the first place. We are sure it's not forming there anymore. It does mean there's a limited amount. Unfortunately, also means one day it is going to run out. But the estimate we have found close to 20% of the mineable gold that's here on Earth. This lucky bar, though, not going to run out, gets to go back in the furnace and can melt it back down. It takes around about 10 or so minutes for the bottom part to melt, another 10, and it's completely liquid. If you did enjoy today's show, then please come back in 45 minutes. I'll tell you the exact same thing again. Thanks, guys. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.